Good evening. Today we'll see how to print the pattern of numbers. In our previous lecture, we have seen how to print the pattern of stars. Consider this example given to you. Your task is to print this pattern of numbers. If you see on the first row, there is a digit 1. On second row, digit 1 and 2. On third row, digits 1, 2 and 3. On fourth row, digit 1, 2, 3 and 4. On fifth row, digit 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now, if you see this pattern as an image, suppose a matrix say, which has 5 rows and 5 columns. We'll see the C code to implement this program. We'll start with the header files, that is hash include stdio.h, hash include conio.h, void main. Then we declare all the variables here, which are required in the program. So there is a mistake here, that is two semicolons are given. Consider it as only one semicolon on this line. Then clear screen will print, clear the screen. This nested for loop will actually print the pattern of numbers here. Now if you see the pattern carefully, on every row the number of digits are increasing. Correct. So we will take a forward loop, outer loop, where I equals to 1, I less than equal to 5, I plus plus, which indicates that there are 5 rows, and the inner for loop is responsible for printing the pattern of numbers. We will start with 1 because on every row the number is starting with 1. Correct. So we will assign j equal to 1, and how many digits we want on every row? I times, right? So we'll write a condition in such a way that it prints I times the number of digits. J less than equal to I, J plus plus here. Previously we were printing star here. Instead of that, we are printing now a number. We want a number here. So we can write I or we can write J, but in this program we'll write J because we want to print the values in increasing order. On every row, the digits is in the increasing order, correct? So we'll use J to print the above pattern in this program. After completing one row, to go to the next row, we use slash in here. This printf line will shift the cursor to the next row. So this ends the outer for loop. Get stage will hold the output somewhere on the screen, and this closing bracket will end the program. Now we'll see the hand run, how this nested for loop will going to print the above pattern. We'll start with the outer for loop where I is equals to 1, condition is true. This inner for loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 1, j plus plus. It means one time this loop will going to be executed, and it will going to print the value of j, that is the value of j is 1. On the first row it prints one digit, and that is 1. Because j value was 1 in that iteration, correct? After printing that, this line shift the cursor to the next row, slash n, will shift the cursor to the next row. From here, it increments the value of I. I value becomes 2, condition is true, and the inner loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 2, j plus plus. It means j will start with 1, it goes till 2. When j is 1, it prints 1 on that row. When j becomes 2, it prints 2 on that row. When j becomes 3, it stops the execution of that code on the second row. It means on the second row, you will find the digit that is 1 and 2. Then this will shift the cursor to the third row. I gets incremented by 1, that is becomes 3. Condition becomes true. It allows us to execute the inner code again, where j becomes 1, j less than or equal to 3, j plus plus. It means that this loop will going to print j values on the third row as 1, 2 and 3 here. After that, this shift the cursor to the fourth row, I becomes 4, this loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 4, j plus plus. It means that this will going to execute the code 4 times, and will going to print the values of j as 1, 2, 3 and 4 on the fourth row. After completing that, it goes to the next line by this printf line. cursor goes to increment the value of I, value of I becomes 5, and the condition becomes true here. The inner for loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 5, j plus plus. So it will going to print 5 digits, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 on the fifth row. After that, this line will again shift the cursor to the sixth row. From here, it goes to increment the value of I, and the value of I now becomes 6. When I value becomes 6, the outer condition becomes false and it stops the execution of the code. So at the end, you will find this pattern on the screen. Okay, do you have any doubt now in this program? You can ask me now. Thank you for watching this video.